you. Some of you I don't know. I'm glad to see you for the first time. My name is Kim Blendenning, and in the district here, I'm the Director of Health Services. But in October, when we were fortunate to win the Carolyn White Fitness Grant, which was a very competitive PE wellness grant, I transitioned over to a part-time grant coordinator as well. And so part of the responsibilities for that have been to implement the activities that we wrote into the grant, to work with community partners such as Dr. Ron and Jamie Buck, who is in here. There you go. We have 25 community partners that we work with through the grant, and we're going to be doing various activities with. But tonight, sponsored by Dr. Ran, is especially significant to the nutrition portion of our wellness grant. And the movie that he brought to us tonight, Hungry for Change, is going to address and I think open our eyes to some impressive areas of growth for all of us. So I want to thank him for that. I'm going to ask him to come up here in just a minute and tell you a little bit more about the movie. But I did just want to spend a second and give you a little more information about the grant that you'll hear something about. If you haven't heard much about it, you will be. The grant that I mentioned that we won on the federal level and that I'm part implementing here is a three-year grant. The district won over $600,000 from at the federal level to be divided out over 3 years to focus on especially improving our physical education curriculum, improving our nutrition and our wellness education in the school. Part of the joy of that has been to work with these 25 different community partners that I mentioned, and we have so many different connections between the fire department, Byron Forest Preserve, the golf course, people that have said and that have agreed with us that we need to be conscious of the wellness of our students. And one of the compelling facts that motivated us was when we heard that this generation of children right now are the first generation that will likely not outlive their parents because of health and wellness issues. And that kind of shakes us all. So it's been great to get these other community partners, businesses, and individuals who have the same passion to work with us. Some of the things that we're going to be doing as a district, and some of the things we have already done, we brought in a whole new PE curriculum for our teachers. They were able to purchase through the grant iPads with Wi-Fi, and if any of you are in education, I think you appreciate that that's a pretty coveted piece of equipment for them. They're doing things like streaming in little YouTube how-tos for their kids. They're able to tape the kids practicing, learning new things, and also keeping track of data. As you know, with anything that has federal attached to it, they give you, you have to give back, so we have a huge responsibility to provide a lot of data to them. We're measuring things like how many steps our students take. One of our purchases was 900 kilometers that rotate through our 2,000 students, and they measure their steps for a week at a time. We record that data. It needs to go back to the government, but it has been very eye-opening for us when the American Heart Association says that the amount of steps a day for healthy activity is 9,100 or 10,000. The staff had a chance to wear pedometers for a while, and I think we were all shocked. You know, the students have really, many of them have commented how challenging it's been for them to see how little activity they get, and then some of them way off the charts. So we're collecting data. We're assessing their nutrition, and they're taking surveys about how many fruits and vegetables they take in a week's time. Keeping track of activities. Those are some of the things we're monitoring in the district, and the goal would be to see where we're at in the baseline, which was just a couple months ago, and see where we end up at the end of the 3 years. We're also going to be starting summer camps funded through the grant, and that'll be in June this summer coming. We'll be offering it for our K-8 students, and there'll just be opportunities for them to come and experience fitness and wellness in a hopefully really exciting way. Been working really hard at that. I'm going to start after school programs in the fall, and that's also a part of this grant. So there's just been a lot of activity going on, and again, just coordinating with the community has been really exciting to just get other people's passion together and see what we can do for our kids. So that's a little bit about the Cardinal Flight to Fitness. When you hear that from here on out, I hope that you think about the grant and hope that you associate your first experience.
I guess my first question is, has anybody seen Food Matters? So this is a continuation of that movie, kind of. The first Food Matters is more vitamin-based, what we're missing in our food. This one is how our food's prepared, those kinds of things. This is actually a brand new movie. It just came out March 20th. So this, I ordered it on March 20th, and it just got out this last week. So it's a very new movie, so it's not very many people have seen it. It's not real scary, but it's kind of eye-opening. So all I ask of you is to use an open mind when you're watching this, okay? Because they're not up there trying to sell you anything. And these are the experts in the field. That's the other thing. These are the leading health experts and food experts that are available to teach